We are joined by Fort Lauderdale Interim Police Chief Karen Dietrich. You may follow at Fort Lauderdale PD on Facebook, Instagram, and on Twitter. Chief Dietrich, how you doing today?
I'm doing very well, Brian. How are you?
Yeah, likewise. You know, certainly it's been another challenging several days in law enforcement, just the horrific events last weekend in Compton, California. I can't help but to think of local enforcement when moments like that arise. Do incidents like what happened in Compton create increased risk within our own community?
Absolutely, Brian. You know, anytime one of these attacks takes place, you know, our heart goes out to the families and the department and the community in that area. But it does create a more dangerous environment for all of us, because people who do these cowardly acts, they're just looking for attention. And you have those people who want to emulate what they saw, or even maybe take it up a notch just for a little bit of notoriety. And I tell you, I really have to give it to the two L.A. deputies. Their will to survive and fight through what happened to make it out alive is exactly the mindset that we try to train our officers to have. Being critically injured and then trying to remain calm enough to put a tourniquet on your partner and save your partner's life, that's a true testament to her training. But we see these events, and we don't just let them go by. You know, we take them, we look at the videos, we analyze them, we see what we can learn from them, and we add them to our training. We've had several people in the business community that they offer us up help, like items like abandoned buildings to train in. And those are important factors. But unfortunately, unless you have your head on a swivel every second that you're in uniform, some of these situations are just no win. Because, Brian, you got to realize action beats reaction every time. And we're always reacting to a situation or a threat. So somewhat we're kind of behind the eight ball all the time.
Well, law enforcement, I mean, human. And I would think it would be human nature to see what happened in Compton, where you have a couple of officers in their car and that happens. I would think that would impact the mindset of those just, you know, out on patrol. At this point, do you have to think of things differently, look at things differently, and even be concerned just sitting in that vehicle?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it makes us angry. And then to watch the actions of people at that hospital while those deputies were fighting for their life, there's just no reason for that. All they did was go to work to protect people. And it just makes me kind of wonder what happened to the world. But we definitely, we position our cars differently. We, you know, we watch more attentively. We have to change the way we do things, because the days of being able to sit in a car and look down at your computer or write a report, those days are over. Your life could end for no other reason that you're just sitting in a car with a uniform on.
To this point, have there been any members of the Fort Lauderdale Police Department that have taken a look at this and gone, you know what, this just isn't for me anymore?
We have had some retirements, and I'm sure that that plays into it. You know, you spend 20, 25, 30 years in a job, and you see what's happening with the world, and you have to ask yourself, is it worth it anymore? And I'm sure that that plays a big part in some of the officers who've been here for 20, 25 years, absolutely.
And for what she's saying, this is why it's so critically important that we back the badge. We support those who leave their families every day and never know what's going to happen next. We need good people that want to do this job, because where are we if it gets to the point to where good people no longer want to enter this profession, and those that are in the profession don't want to do it anymore themselves? And that's not a conversation we ever want to find ourselves having. It's why it's just so critically important that we are there for our local law enforcement. Chief Dietrich, how's Phase 2 gone so far?
You know, it only started 3 days ago, and in Broward, we really haven't seen any immediate changes that affect us. You know, our big change will be when they open up the bars. But so far, you know, we don't have much problem. We continue to work closely with code enforcement and keep educating everybody in our jurisdiction on mask placement and the importance of it and so forth and so on. But I don't think we're going to see a whole lot of issues until the bars open.
Okay. It seems like, by and large, people have become more responsible as time's gone along. Has that been your observation?
Yeah, you're always going to have one extreme to the other. But for the most part, people are wearing their masks and they're abiding by the rules. They know it's a public safety it's a medical issue. I don't see a whole lot of problems with it here. We've had to educate more people on the boats, because, you know, they get out, they believe that they're out in the open and it's not going to be a problem. But, you know, we still have the rules that we have to abide by.
any developments? The family of Caleb Field looking for answers still at this point. Any developments in that particular case?
Not as of yet. The family met with our PIO, and we've put an outreach out to see if we can get somebody to come forward and explain why this father of four lost his life. We did recover some surveillance video, and the scene captured multiple witnesses in the area at the time that it happened, but no one's come forward yet. As always, we strongly encourage the members of the community to exercise their voice, help us improve the safety of their community. And anonymous tips are always welcome. They don't have to walk in the doors of the police station. They can be directed to Broward Crime Stoppers, and that number is 954-493-TIPS, and it'll remain completely anonymous. But you have four kids without a father, so somebody's got to come forward.
Yeah, for sure. Well, Chief, thank you so much for taking the time with us and sharing the information for what you do. Everybody who serves with you, we certainly do appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Brian. We really appreciate the support.
Absolutely. That is Fort Lauderdale's Interim Police Chief Karen Dietrich, and you may follow on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter at Fort Lauderdale PD.